Xu Weizhou, also known as Timmy Xu, is a Chinese singer-songwriter and actor who rose to prominence when he took the role of Bai Luo Yin in the popular 2016 web series Addicted Heroin, the TV adaptation of the Chinese gay romantic novel Are You Addicted? He then made history by becoming the first solo Chinese artist to rank number one on both the Billboard China V charts and Mandarin chart at the same time. Xu Weizhou was born on the 20th of October 1994 in Shanghai, China. His parents came from a middle-class background, and he was exposed to music early on in life, and his father plays the drums. Growing up, he listened to the music of Jackie Chung, Rene Lu, and Waka Chow. He was inspired to learn how to play the guitar after listening to the music of Linkin Park. He also learned Latin dance as a young teen, motivated by a pair of shiny shoes. His mother told him that only those who knew Latin dance movements were deserving of such shoes. He ended up learning dancing skills for about 10 years. Do you want to win one of these items on your screen? If so, make sure to watch the whole video, leave a like and comment a hidden message. And with that being said, let's get ready to watch the video. He went to local Shanghai elementary school and then attended the affiliated senior high school of the Shanghai Theater Academy. After high school, he moved to Beijing and graduated from the National Academy of Chinese Theater Arts in May 2017 with a major in acting. Prior to his acting debut, he was part of two amateur metal rock bands, Prom and Agache, that he helped form with his high school classmates and friends, and was chosen as the leader of both bands. Then during his third year in college, he was scouted and offered a part in a movie. In October of 2015, Timmy accepted a lead role in a coming-of-age short movie, but without any great expectations. He would often become anxious when most of the seniors in college warned him that actors had a difficult time gaining parts after graduation, and he felt grateful that he was given an opportunity that early on in life. Working on the short film was just like doing a college play project for him, although his acting debut wasn't seen by many people. With his tall frame and good looks, he was part of several photo shoots, and from there he was invited to be part of a web series as one of the lead actors. He readily agreed without any idea at all that his life was about to change with this controversial role. The web series entitled Addicted Heroin was a TV adaptation of the popular Chinese gay romantic novel Are You Addicted? Written by Chai Jiden. It consisted of 15 episodes with a production budget of just over $740,000, the equivalent of 5 million yen at the time. Timmy played Bai Luo Yin, a high school student who developed a romantic relationship with his stepbrother, Huang Jingyu, played by Johnny Huang. Due to his songwriting skills and budget constraints, Timmy was also tapped to produce both the opening and closing parts of the official soundtrack of the series. The series became a huge hit, both locally and internationally, sparking the interest of millions of viewers, but also the ire of Chinese conservatives. Eventually, the Chinese government banned the last three episodes from being shown on any Chinese network or website. There was a huge clamor from the public for the last three episodes to be available for streaming or downloading, but the censorship board ignored these pleas. Instead, it even triggered a crackdown on all series depicting any love interest between LGBTQ couples, extending the ban to adultery, one-night stands, underage relationships, and even reincarnation, all now considered to be illegal on screen. The producers of the web series eventually aired the last three episodes on YouTube, but only international fans were able to view them. It was one of the most difficult months in Timmy's life, saying in an interview that he experienced both the highs and the lows from doing the one project. The Chinese government even ordered him and his co-star, Johnny Wong, to never be seen together in any type of project. During a fan meeting in Thailand for the web series, security would separate the two during photo shoots or anything that would allow them to appear in one frame. While he gained so much popularity because of the series, Timmy thought it was the end of it all, since there were no acting offers, even after the controversy about the series died down. He was just starting to make a name for himself, but the doors were already closing in on him. Fortunately, his love for music saved his career from fading away. Instead of waiting for acting roles, Timmy focused on his music career. His father initially discouraged him and told him that if he wasn't persistent about pursuing a singing career, he should forget about it. He released a self-produced studio album entitled Light in May of 2016, consisting of 7 songs, 6 of which were self-compositions. Banking on the burst of fame he received from the web series, he released a couple of songs, including one of the theme songs of his controversial series, Walk Slowly, and boldly promoted them in several addicted heroin fan meetings. It worked, and he regained momentum, so by the time the full album was available to the public, over 10,000 units were sold within 15 minutes of release. He went on his first Asian concert tour entitled First Light Asia Tour, which kicked off in Beijing. It was reported that tickets were sold out within 3 minutes. Then he flew to Bangkok, Thailand, where apparently it took only 36 seconds for the VIP tickets of his concert to be sold out. He also went to Seoul, South Korea, and made his history by being the first solo Chinese artist to ever hold a concert there. Timmy then flew back home and performed in 3 other key cities in mainland China. 2017 proved to be a great year for his fledgling singing career. In March, Timmy was chosen to sing The Heroes, the original soundtrack or OST of the Canadian film entitled Snowtime, originally sung by Simple Plan. Upon the release of the song, he made history as the first solo Chinese artist to top both already mentioned charts. Then in May, he was the first ever Chinese solo artist from mainland China to be invited to Las Vegas to attend the Billboard Music Awards. In the same month, Timmy was chosen to play the lead role in a short movie, Seize the Moment, produced by Vogue China, with Chun Jia, directed by Park Sher. The full album entitled This Time was physically released in July of 2018, his second studio album being divided into 4 parts in the form of extended plays, or EPs, and digitally released from August 2017 to January 2018. The first EP, 15 Minutes of Craziness, reputedly reached debut platinum status after 3 minutes and 3 seconds. The following 3 EP releases, 15 Minutes of Radiance, 15 Minutes of Monologue, and 15 Minutes of Fantasy, were just as successful, with a total of almost 500,000 units sold. Most of the songs charted in the top 3 of major music charts, including Billboard Radio China, China V, and Fresh Asia Music Charts. Timmy became very visible on Chinese variety shows, and in the first half of the year, he was included in the top 10 most popular variety stars. With the success of his music career and continuous variety star presence, he was chosen for several product campaigns and luxury brand endorsements, including Louis Vuitton, Givenchy, and Tiffany & Company, and was the first Chinese star to be chosen as an ambassador of South Korea cosmetic brand Laneige. Due to the success of his singing the OST of a Canadian film, he was tapped to sing the theme songs for a couple of English-speaking movies too. Ruins of Time for the British Chinese-produced movie SMART Chase, and Maze for the movie Maze Runner: The Death Cure. Timmy was now considered one of the top singers in mainland China and was included in the lineup of performers of the 3 most popular TV networks in China, Beijing TV, Dragon Television, and Anhui Television for the Chinese Spring Festival galas. He was also making waves around the rest of Asia, particularly in Thailand, where the digital versions of his second album topped the iTunes chart. His influence on social media platforms grew so large that he was included in the top 10 Chinese artists who have the most number of reposts at over 66 million. 2018 was also the year he made a web series comeback, playing a lead role in the romantic comedy entitled My Girlfriend, aired on the Youku video sharing site. Timmy made his TV acting debut too, with a supporting role in The Evolution of Our Love, aired on Zhejiang TV and Shanghai TV. He was a first-row guest on most fashion shows and store launchings of several global brands, including Balmain, Roberto Cavalli, Superdry Sounds, and Alexander McQueen. Timmy was also the Chinese brand ambassador for Coach. By 2019, Timmy was at number 5 on the most influential fashion male artist in China, as revealed by the annual China Entertainment Index. His influence on Chinese social media platforms led to him being chosen as the global ambassador of the avant-garde fashion house Victor & Rolf, as well as Fendi, and a walk in their summer-spring 2020 Men's Milan Fashion Week. He also took part in the Beijing Winter Olympics countdown and was chosen as the official ambassador of the event. The global pandemic caused by COVID-19 didn't stop him from staying busy. He has filmed 6 TV series, including Midsummer is Full of Hearts, the Chinese TV adaptation of the popular South Korean drama series Full House. 5 of the 6 drama series will feature him as the lead character, and the other will be a cameo role. The schedule of the airing of those dramas will be for the year 2020-2021. Timmy is currently single, with no reports of dating of any kind. His social media posts are mostly about work and his travels. Due to his sincere portrayal in the gay romance web series Addicted Heroin, fans wonder if he is gay in real life, but Timmy is straight, and sometime in August of 2019 was involved in a dating scandal with Chris Wu's rumored girlfriend, Luyi Luna. When the rumored relationship was uncovered by the press, some fans couldn't accept it and created a story that Luyi Luna was also dating Timmy at the same time. Timmy posted a denial on his Weibo account, putting an end to the possible controversy. His ideal girl would be someone who is cute and smart, resembling the personality of actress Lin Qiling. Further items of interest in Timmy's life include his preferred nickname of Zhaozhou, that he wears corrective lenses with a grade of -2, and that one of his hidden talents is that he can wiggle his ears. Among his many favorite artists are Bruno Mars and Chester Bennington of Linkin Park, of Western influence, and Asian Zhuang Yihong and Lin Qiling. As a singer, he likes to try various types of music genres, such as hip-hop, trap, and EDM, but his favorites are death metal and emotional hardcore. Recently, he got into jazz music. During off days, he would write songs, play his guitar, watch anime, read books, and play video games. Curiously, Timmy would often tell stylists that he prefers using gold accessories during promotions. Nothing but the best. In appearance, Timmy is 6 feet 2 inches or 1.87 meters tall, weighs around 150 pounds or 68 kilograms, and his shoe size is 10. He has black hair and dark brown eyes. Finally, according to the authoritative Forbes, Timmy has an estimated net worth of $3.5 million as of early 2021. Thank you for spending some time with us. Make sure to like and subscribe so you never miss another video. We also handpick these videos, which we recommend you watch next. You can talk to us on all social medias or ask a question in the comments below. Thank you for being with us, and we'll see you back tomorrow.